I have no idea what's in this box. It is a mystery parcel. Well, its contents are a mystery, but its arrival isn't. And whatever's inside, I'm going to make a robot with. Today's video is something completely different. It is a challenge collaboration. I've teamed up with three of my favorite YouTube channels, 8bits and a Byte, TechnoChic and Make It and Fake It, and we've all sent each other $25 worth of stuff. The rules are really simple. Take the stuff and make it into a robot. You can use whatever electronics and other stuff you have around, but you have to use all the stuff that you were sent. If you want to see what wonderful and thoughtful and not at all awkward stuff I sent to Natasha from TechnoChic, I'm going to put a link to her video and all the other videos that the collaborators made in the description box and a bit later on in this video. I definitely recommend you go and check out all their channels because they're amazing and you should definitely subscribe. But that is enough introduction for now because I am dying to know what is inside this box. It's been sat on my shelf for like weeks waiting to film this video and the curiosity is just too much to bear. Let's open it. My God, it's actually really light. It's like under a kilo. I have no idea what's in here. All I can hear is bubble wrap. Oh, I'm actually quite nervous now. I'm so scared. What if it's unrobotable? My hands are actually shaking, genuinely. Drum roll, please. Plastic plant pots. I'm so excited, I can't even say the word. Colourful plastic plant pots. And leaves. This is great. I mean, I've got a theme already. It's definitely going to be some kind of like creepy crawly plant, I guess. I was expecting to have like no ideas and for it to be really difficult. And instead, I've got like too many. Oh, let's have a closer look at the stuff. There is so much of it. Oh, this is, okay, it smells a bit weird. It smells a bit weird, but we can fix that. I wonder if I could make it like shoot bits of this or swing around like Tarzan style or, oh my God, what am I gonna make it do? Oh, I've never been happier to receive plastic ivy. Well, I'm delighted. I'm gonna need to have a think and then I will come back to it. Okay, so I've had my thinking time, and I think I know what I'm going to do. My first instinct with these pots was to make some kind of robot friend that would follow the light or shoot ivy at your ankles or something. But then I remembered the use everything stipulation of the challenge, and yeah, I think it was meant to mean use some of all the things you were given, rather than neglecting or leaving out any of the items. But I think I actually can use everything. First, the fact that I've got all these plant pots gave me the idea to use each one as a sensor in a network. Not a robot in the traditional sense, but maybe connecting them up distributed around the house with the ivy to hide the wires, making a sort of smart plant net. I think in my head I thought that was a pun. Now I'm not so sure. Internet? Ivy net? That's something. But then I realised that all the plant pots are different colours. Wow! Great observational skills, Hannah. And I wondered if I could use that fact, incorporate it into the project somehow. So maybe have a secret colour combination lock where you have to arrange all of the pots in order of their colour in order to unlock something. But that doesn't really use the ivy. So what I'm planning on doing is having the pots arranged on a shelf with the ivy trailing between them, all inconspicuous, but really, they're switches for my smart lights. You go up to the shelf, you take one of the pots off its little tray, put it down again, and the lights turn the colour of the pot. Not really a robot, but it is pretty cool. That's the plan. What do I need to do first? Probably the pot switches. I've had to pause video production because somebody has invaded the workshop. Maisie, what do you want with all that ivy? This is my stuff, you can't sit here. Maisie, you're right in the middle of my desk. Be like your sister and sit on the floor. Let me move that one for you. I'll tuck that in. There are a few ways we could turn these into switches. We could go with pressure sensors, we could go for light sensors even. But in my experience, it's better to go lower tech where possible because it just makes it a bit less complicated when it comes to troubleshooting. So I'm gonna go with copper tape. Okay, this is hard. Oh, it's sticking to itself. Oh God, it's just awful. It's not pretty, but it'll do. If you're following along at home, don't. Go and do a better project. Look at one of my other videos. Again, not that aesthetically pleasing, but it doesn't need to be. I'm pretty convinced that copper bits of both of those make contact when the pot's in the saucer. That should be fine. Safety first. I think this is my new profile picture for sure. Now I am going to test the switch that I've just created. I've left these wires ridiculously long because the shelf that these are going on is like 2 meters or more, and I could daisy chain the ground connections, which would mean they'd only need to be as long as the distance between two pots. But since all the other wires will need to go to a different pin on the microcontroller and the ivy is going to hide everything anyway, I don't care. So, about testing this, I have an LED and a battery, and they go that way round. Now, if the two bits of copper tape that the wires are connected to are making contact, then when I touch the other end of the wire to this leg of the LED, it should light up. That looks like a switch to me. Just 7 more to go. It is really bothering me that one of these pots has a little tray that's not in the matching colour. I've just had a brilliant idea. What if I make this pot turn the lights a random colour? Yeah. Yeah, that'll do it. That'll do it. Yes. I gotta finish the wiring first. Okay, let's put all of this stuff away and do some coding. To give you a brief rundown of how this works, I'm using a trick that I used in a previous project. If this, then that. In my Alexa-controlled pumpkin project, I wanted to use Alexa as the trigger and then have my project do something as a result. This time, I want to use my project as the trigger and then have something else happen, which makes things even easier. I can use webhooks. If this, then that gives me a magic URL. And if I make HTTP requests to the magic URL, it can handle the rest. So there's not actually that much coding. The program checks to see whether one of my pot switches has been broken. And if it has, it sends an HTTP request to the magic URL saying what color pot it was. If this, then that handles the rest. Simple in concept, but let's set it up and see if it's as simple in real life. Ta-da! The nearly finished thing. I've left all the wires exposed for troubleshooting purposes, but fingers crossed we won't need to do any of that because it should just work. Shall we see? Okay. Green. Okay, purple. Yes! White. How brilliant is this? Blue. Pink. Not pink, but the other colours worked. Orange. Okay, pink still doesn't work, but all in all, I'm gonna call that a success. That's not the color I asked you to go. Close. Blue. Orange. Oh, it's all gone to sh** again. Oh well. Stop. Stop. I don't really know what's going on at this point. I think some of the wires are a bit messed up. I give up. I'm just gonna stick some ivy on it and hope that improves the situation. And that's it in all its glory. Shall we have one final demonstration of it working perfectly? Now I have rewired some of the pots. Okay. Green. Ta-da! Purple. Ta-da! Orange. Ta-da! And back to white. A humongous thank you to Nicole from 8 Bits and a Byte for sending me this phenomenal combination of items. My cats loved the ivy more than anything I've ever bought for them, so that's an added bonus. Definitely check out 8 Bits and a Byte, Make It and Fake It, and TechnoChic, because they are three phenomenal challenges? Three phenomenal channels? That's the second time I've fluffed that line, we're just gonna leave it in. They are three phenomenal channels that deserve your love, and more than that, your subscription. So as ever, there will be links to all of the other robot challenge videos in the description box and around and about. But that's it. Leaving me to wonder why I didn't add a pot to switch the lights off. Bye. I have no idea when to point. Safety first. Let's try that again. Green. What have the cats done? Cats, stop throwing things out of the cupboards. Maisie, you're such a horrible cat. That's all we've got time for. You can't do another take. There's like 3 more seconds left on this memory card. 2, 1.